Okay, a fast example how to use the lasso tool in GIMP or pre-selection tool is also the correct name. Okay, let's go. So here we have this boat image. First, we want to enlarge it, say 200%. And now we want to move this layer area here. So we press spacebar key and keep it down and move it, the layer around. So now we go and take the lasso tool, and you can find it here in the tools palette. And now we go around the boat with the lasso tool. We start here, we press the mouse button, and we start going the boat edges around, and we use the space bar key to move the area when needed. And here we could zoom in more to be able to do more exact job here. And if you hit something wrong, you can always go back with the backspace key. And then continue working. Now we have to decide if we want to take the shadow width, and I think that I want to take it because it might look good in the target picture. You can also use the freehand tool here by keeping the mouse button pressed and then try drawing there, but it's not so exact, and I like using this style better. And you close the selection by clicking on the first point here. So now it's closed. And now we can zoom out, and here it is. And the next thing is that we are going to copy the boat on the clipboard. But first we use the feather tool to make the selection area edges or boundaries more soft, so that they are not too sharp. So let's do that. We take the select menu here, and here is the feather tool. And this is, well, I think in a picture like this, 2 pixels would be enough. So we take OK. And then we copy. And now it's in the clipboard, and we open the target image. which is river.xcf. So this is the GIMP file format. And now we paste the boat here. We take edit, and we could use this normal paste function here, but a better way is to use paste as new layer, because if we use this, it's all right, but we have to change it to a normal layer later. So all the same, we make it now. And wow, it's a big one, so we have to make it smaller. We take layer menu, because now we talk about layer. You can see the layer here, pasted layer. Actually, we could change the name, double clicking and then writing boat and enter. So this is the boat layer. And we make it smaller, scale layer. And now we just have to try. I think 800 pixels could be quite good. And when you press the tabulator or click the mouse in the next height area, so you can see that it changes too. I think 800 is too much, so I'm gonna try with 600, and then I click scale. Okay, looks good. And now I have the lasso tool still here, so I want to change it to move tool, because I don't wanna use the lasso anymore. So I click here, and now I have the move tool in my mouse, so I can move this layer around here. And I want to make the bow direct to right, so I take layer and transform and flip horizontally. Okay, and then I want to move it here. And as I have this problem in the bow, I move it out of the picture. Problem solved. Okay, and now I have these boundaries here that I want to get rid of. So I go here to view menu, and here, show layer boundary. No, I don't want to show them, so I click them off. So it looks nicer now. And okay, hey, I think there is some problem with the color. I think that it's too magenta, so I can correct it also here. I have this boat layer chosen, so I go to colors, color balance, and I think it's too much magenta, so I move it right toward the green. Not too much. I think that would be quite good, and maybe too much blue as well, so I move the blue slider toward yellow. Too much is too much. Okay, maybe here. And then, okay. And now it's ready. It's good enough for me. So I save the file, and I want to make it a GIMP file at first. So I take save as, and I only change the name to river and boat.xcf, because I want to keep it in the GIMP format here, I press save. And okay, I seem to have the file here already, so I replace it. And now it's saved. And then I want to save this in JPEG format, so I go to File, but now I can't use the Save As command, so I have to use Export. So I click Export, and see, because I have used this JPEG before, so it that's why it offers it to me now. But if it offers something else, so then you have to choose the right format here. For example, if you have used PNG before, so it might offer that to you. So you just select here JPEG image and press export and replace, because I had it already there. And now I have to choose the quality settings here. The better the quality, the bigger the image file size. But if I want to make the file size as small as possible, so I lose the quality. So I choose, okay, I choose 80%, and then I click export. And now let's see what I have. Here I have the Riverboat XCF, the GIMP file, and here I have the Riverboat JPEG that I can use in web pages, blogs, or send to my comrade, or whatever. It's here. Looks good. And if we take a look at the file sizes between the JPEG and XCF GIMP file format, so there's a huge difference. This is 344 kilobytes, and the GIMP file is almost 3 megabytes. So that's Lasso Tool. Thank you for watching.